Along with signaling our move from winter into spring, this March will also usher in a ton of new streaming options heading to Netflix throughout the month. Among the new additions, you'll find a lot of movie treasures, including a bounty of romantic comedies, dramas, fantasy adventures, and action thrillers. Here's a look at some of the hidden gems you'll be able to stream in March. Ryan Gosling fans finally got to watch the actor embrace his status as an utter heartthrob in the 2011 romantic comedy Crazy Stupid Love, which hits on March 1st. Gosling stars as Jacob, a debonair ladies' man who dresses to impress and always has a pickup line at the ready.
I guarantee you this, you're never gonna regret going home with that guy from the bar that one time that was a total tomcat in the sack. But I can't guarantee that you won't not regret it.
That's a double negative.
You're a double negative.
Better yet, he's also pretty hilarious opposite Steve Carell, who stars as Cal, a middle-aged man who's in the middle of divorce and has absolutely no clue how to talk to women. After witnessing Cal crash and burn at a bar, Jacob decides to give his new friend a makeover and help him step up his game. The buddy comedy that commences between them is both funny and heartwarming.
Take your ring off, let's go.
The film's cast is rounded out by other A-listers turning in memorable performances, including Julianne Moore as Cal's estranged wife, Emily. Emma Stone is Jacob's quirky love interest, Hannah. Kevin Bacon is Emily's co-worker turned lover. And Marissa Tomei is Cal's wild date, Kate. Meanwhile, the script for Crazy Stupid Love was written by This Is Us creator Dan Fogelman, who knows a thing or two about pulling on heartstrings. Speaking of writers who go right for the feels, nobody does it quite like Nicholas Sparks. And Knights in Rodanthe is one of his most emotional adaptations of all. The 2008 drama, which drops on March 1st, stars Diane Lane as Adrienne Willis, a soon-to-be divorced woman who temporarily takes care of her friend's beachside bed and breakfast. Meanwhile, Richard Gere stars as Paul, a doctor who's dealing with a devastating career setback and a strained relationship with his son when he arrives as the only guest at the cozy inn. Amid a swelling storm, Adrian and Paul grow close to one another and learn to heal from their individual wounds together. The only question is, what will happen if and when they venture away from their little piece of paradise? Knights in Rodanthe is helmed by Ma Rainey's Black Bottom director George C. Wolfe and marks the third on-screen collaboration by Lane and Gere, who bring plenty of chemistry to the screen in this steamy seaside love tale. Actor Hugh Grant and writer-director Mark Lawrence have frequently collaborated on beloved projects. But the pick that first brought the two talents together was the charming 2002 romantic comedy 2 Weeks Notice, which comes on March 1st.
Why are pediatrics so important to Wade?
Well, I think feet are very important, aren't they? No, I'm just teasing, Gina. I know there's much more to pediatrics than feet.
The film features Grant as George Wade, a billionaire who's well-meaning and kind, but constantly demands attention from his chief counsel Lucy Kelson, played by Sandra Bullock. She finally draws the line and submits her resignation.
George, I think you're the most selfish human being on the planet.
That's just silly. Have you met everyone on the planet?
Goodbye, George.
I don't have a shirt.
However, not only does George go to extremes to stop her from being hired elsewhere, but she starts to realize that she's developing romantic feelings for him. What results is a lighthearted and humorous professional breakup that might just mark the start of a personal relationship between them. Roald Dahl's library of children's fantasy books has always been a prime source of memorable Hollywood adaptations, and The BFG is one of his latest stories to get the silver screen treatment. Legendary director Steven Spielberg adapted Dahl's celebrated novel into a live-action movie in 2016. Resulting in a sweeping fantasy adventure with amazing visuals and touching take on the story. The BFG, which arrives on March 15th, stars Ruby Barnhill as Sophie, an orphaned girl in London who is captured by the big friendly giant, voiced and portrayed through motion capture by Mark Rylance, after Sophie catches a glimpse of him one night.
Well, I had to take you, because the first thing you'd be doing, you'd be scuttling around and yodeling the news that you were actually seeing a giant.
While the BFG is certainly larger than life in Sophie's world, he's considered a runt in giant country, which is run by even larger giants who have a hunger for humans. Together, Sophie and her giant navigate their own worlds and the dream world to try and stop his people-eating peers from attacking even more humans. Not only is the movie brimming with stunning scenery and CGI magic, but audiences will instantly fall in love with its pint-sized protagonist and her big best friend. Writer-director Oliver Stone is well known for his work on crime thrillers. but there's something special about what he pulls off with his 2012 adaptation of Don Winslow's Savages, which will be available to stream on March 16th. The unique thriller features Aaron Taylor-Johnson and Taylor Kitsch as Ben and Sean, a pair of best friends who run a successful marijuana business and have an open relationship with Blake Lively's Ophelia Sage. They both have to prepare for a big fight, however, after they decline an opportunity to work for the cartel, which results in Ophelia getting kidnapped. Soon, they find themselves way over their heads in a violent drug war.
You nervous?
No. I hijack cash shipments all the time.
Alongside the trio at the center of this twisty love triangle, the film also stars Selma Hayek as the drug boss Elena Sanchez, Benicio del Toro as her henchman, Demian Bashir as cartel member Alex Reyes, and John Travolta as a crooked DEA agent named Dennis Kane. All of these characters eventually come together for a violent clash that redefines the phrase, all's fair in love and war. Dame Judi Dench earned her 7th and most recent Oscar nomination for her depiction of Philomena Lee in the 2014 biopic about an Irish woman's 50-year search for her son who was taken away from her as a toddler. Philomena, which arrives on March 22nd, features Dench alongside Steve Coogan, who portrays the down-on-his-luck journalist Martin Sixsmith as he reluctantly agrees to investigate Philomena's case. As the two chase leads to find her son's potential whereabouts, Sixsmith becomes heavily involved in the investigation, even as it yields some heartbreaking revelations. Despite the heaviness of the circumstances, the two develop an unlikely bond that marks a new start for both of them.
I won't write anything you're unhappy with, I just want to tell the truth.
Yes, that's the thing I'm worried about.
Mandela Long Walk to Freedom is an emotionally resonant biopic that's scheduled to drop on March 29th. The film features Idris Elba in a celebrated depiction of former South African President Nelson Mandela, following his life's journey from his youth to his rise as an anti-apartheid leader, his long-term imprisonment, and eventually to his historic term as a president who fought to end the division of his nation.
It is an ideal which I hope to live for and achieve. But if needs be, it is an ideal for which I am prepared to die.
The film is directed by Justin Chadwick from a script by William Nicholson, who based the screenplay on Mandela's 1995 autobiography of the same name. Elba's powerful performance as one of the world's most respected and honored leaders of all time was critically revered and earned him nominations at the Golden Globes and BET Awards. Dutch painter Vincent van Gogh's work was rarely appreciated in his lifetime, but he's since become one of the most iconic and influential artists ever. At Eternity's Gate, which arrives on March 31st, features Willem Dafoe as the unique painter in his later years as he lived in France and grappled with his isolation and his questions about existence, eternity, and his mental well-being. The film also features Oscar Isaac as fellow eccentric artist Paul Gauguin, and Mads Mikkelsen as an empathetic priest who helps Vincent get released from a mental asylum. Dafoe was nominated for multiple awards for his portrayal of Van Gogh in the film, including at the Oscars and Golden Globes. And the story itself takes some intriguing creative liberties with Van Gogh's known history, including a new interpretation of the circumstances surrounding Van Gogh's final moments. Thanks for watching. Click the links in our video to watch more from Netflix Film Club. Subscribe to our YouTube channel to get the latest exclusive videos. Plus, hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.